Welcome back to the System Administration MiniConf for our last set of four talks for the day. Our first talk is Noharu-san talking about getting started with Linux boot firmware on the Arch 64 server. Over to you, Noharu-san.
Okay. Thank you for introducing me, Ivan. Welcome to this session. I'm Naohiro from Fujitsu. I'm very excited to be here. So let's get started. I'm going to talk about Linux boot Arch 64 using these keywords, two pitfalls, one solution, and five tips. My motivation is that don't repeat my struggle by sharing two pitfalls, one solution, and five tips. Last year, I investigated Linux boot for Arch 64 server project because Linux boot is Mega Data Center customer's requirement for security. In terms of ARMv8, it is becoming important for sysadmin, not only Fujitsu A64FX1 HPC top 500 last June and November, but also Apple M1 and AWS Graviton 2 became available. Bloomberg said Microsoft is planning to. Your merit is that you will be able to explain Linux boot Arch 64 to your boss and colleagues with 100% confidence, because getting Linux box Arch 64 today without purchasing any additional hardware at all. So our goal is to boot Final OS, CentOS 8.2 Arch 64 from Linux boot flash ROM using QEMU and BIOSEM. Please consider CentOS 8.2 as Rail 8.2, which enterprise customer mostly use, and all steps to reproduce are available at my GitHub. What is Linux boot? Linux boot has three meanings, depending on context. Please look at the right-hand side of the figure. It shows the essence of Linux boot. Linux boot consists of three elements: hardware initialized firmware, and ARO, and Linux boot firmware. First meaning as a whole, and the second meaning is as a Linux boot firmware, that is Linux kernel and initramfs. The third meaning is as ARO from UEFI-PEI to Linux boot second. We focus on this because of its for server. In terms of other hardware initialization firmware, Core boot is for laptop, mainly Chromebook, and U-boot is for edge device, and Slim bootloader is relatively new, Intel initiated, so currently it supports only x86. So we focus on the UEFI-PEI. First of all, when we look at the Linux boot official webpage, it says kernel must be built with config EFI-BDS. Follow further instruction on our GitHub. Soon you will notice no such kernel parameter, and the GitHub provides no further instruction. In fact, I finally found BDS kernel patch in Hex repository, which is Core boot initramfs. This kernel patch is to x86 Arch dependent code, So it's not applicable to Arch 64. And basically, what is BDS? Boot device selector. Boot device selector is a phase of UEFI boot. Typically, the VXE dispatcher start boot manager. Instead of boot manager, the Linux boot BDS select flash ROM and start the Linux boot second BDS patched kernel. And not only BDS patched kernel, but also the Linux boot BDS source code is for only x86, but not Arch 64. So this is a second pitfall. So this solution is totally for x86. So what should we do for Arch 64? Solution is a tool called Fiano. Fiano replaces UEFI shell with Linux boot. Then boot manager called Linux boot second. We can put UEFI shell in the first priority using boot manager. Then boot manager called Linux boot as if it were UEFI shell. In this case, kernel doesn't need a patch. So this is a solution to first and second pitfall because kernel patch and BDS source code are not necessary. So how do we create boot and debug flash ROM for Arch 64? There are five tips for Linux boot Arch 64. I'm going to explain one by one. Before that, there is a flash ROM size requirement and challenge. Flash ROM size is 32 megabytes because low-end physical Arch 64 server has only 32 flash ROM. Trusted firmware and UEFI occupies 16 megabytes, and the rest of 16 megabytes can be used for Linux boot. And the challenge is that Arch 64 kernel has to be stored in uncompressed because Arch 64 doesn't support self-decompression PECOF image, but other CPUs support. CentOS 8.2 generic kernel size, gzip 8 megabyte and gungzip 25 megabyte, so three times larger than compressed. So therefore, Linux boot second has to be less than 60 megabyte without kernel compression. So let's get into the all of tips one by one. And tip one, how to create Arch 64 over MF 32 megabyte flash firmware file system. OVMF, Open Virtual Machine Firmware, is UEFI implementation for QEMU and KVM. Its size is only 2 megabytes, so there is no room to replace UEFI shell with Linux boot second. You can see the details at this URL. So how to extend firmware file system to 32 megabytes. The easiest way I found is to increase flash device number of blocks in OVMF source code and actually just update the two files and insert 10 lines and delete one line. Update the 512 blocks to 8192 blocks. Then the file system becomes 32. The patch is available in my GitHub, so apply patch and rebuild OVMF. That's the answer. Tip 2, how to configure Linux boot kernel and initramfs. Linux boot second has to be one file. The kernel and initramfs have to be one file. And the size less have to be less than 16 megabytes. So how to minimize kernel with embedded initramfs? We need to repeat kernel config trial and error using GDB. I listed the essential configuration parameter here. UEFI stub is necessary to be kernel as a UEFI application. And the initramfs source and the compression enables initramfs to be embedded. And we choose uroot as initramfs because it is very small and written in Go language for security. And also we need to disable module and enable ACPI support. Then I finally succeeded in creating a kernel that is 15 megabytes. The all kernel parameters are defined in devconf and it is available in my GitHub. Tip 3, how to inject Linux boot into QEMU 64MB flash ROM. QEMU bug machine requires 64MB flash ROM, but not 32. How to replace UEFI shell with Linux boot second? First, we need to use DD to extend 32MB flash ROM to 64MB, just filling out zero. We can see the detail looking at the OVMF RPM spec file. The command line is here. Then use replace PE32 subcommand of Fiano UTK. There are 3 points that specify input OVMF flash ROM that we created by DD and the Linux boot PEconf image that is 15 megabytes. Then finally, the output Linux boot flash ROM and type this command. Tip 4, how to boot final OS from local disk. CentOS and Rails 8 follows boot loader spec that uroot initramfs hasn't implemented yet. Boot configuration format grab to menu entry is changed. Details can be found in this URL. And how to boot final OS, CentOS 8.2 from local disk using QEMU. First, you need to apply quick hack patch to uroot and rebuild to Linux boot flash ROM. And QEMU command line is very complicated. So there are 3 points. The specify Linux boot flash ROM and machine path that support ACPI and specify final OS, CentOS 8.2 disk image Qcore2. You can find the console, the UEFI start BDS and that is internal shell, but actually this is a Linux boot. So you can see the version number, that is 5.9 we created. So this is a Linux booting stack. Tip 5, how to debug Linux boot at 64 using QEMU and GDB. We need to open two terminals. In terminal 1, we start QEMU with lower S and capital S. In the terminal 2, start GDB and connect through port 134 to QEMU. And when Linux boot kernel doesn't start, GDB debug help us find missing driver. Conclusion. What to do next? We need to develop kernel decompressor UEFI application for Fiano. That Fiano replaces UEFI shell with the decompressor, then decompressor call Linux boot 2 to accommodate more larger kernel. I think it's really peculiar why not only Arch64 kernel support self-decompression implementing. Because each loader such as grub2, uroot, and etc. has to implement the decompressor repeatedly. I found the discussion once on the mailing list around 7 years ago, but no more discussion. And second, we need to watch Linux boot 3rd, ARM company is implementing. At OCP Summit last year, ARM presented Linux boot, which trusted firmware called Linux decompressor skipping UEFI. Looking at this picture, trusted firmware A, profile A, directly called decompressor without UEFI. But we need to implement UEFI runtime API. And when it's ready, we can try it using QEMU SPSA reference machine. This machine simulates hardware. The SPSA server-based system architecture is a standard specification ARM R64 server have to implement. So you can find the detail about SBSA QEMU in this URL. Summary. I explained two pitfalls, one solution, and 5 tips. You can boot Final OS CentOS 8.2 from Linux boot flash ROM using QEMU. All steps to reproduce are available at my GitHub. Try it by yourself and explain what is Linux boot at 64 to your boss and colleagues. Please send me an email or submit an issue to GitHub if you have any problem. Here is a reference that I looked at. And first 3 slides are very informative to understand what is R64 Linux boot. That is the ARM company presented in the other conference. And finally, I'm going to show you my web page, my GitHub page. You can see the each command line for each tip, and I'm sure that if you follow these command line, you can reproduce and you can boot Arch64 Linux boot from flash ROM. So thank you very much. So enjoy the conference.
Thank you very much, Nehuru-san. I have put the links to your slides and also to your GitHub into the chat for people to follow. And your slides are also on the sysadmin.miniconf.org website. So if anyone wants to look up details, they are right there. Hopefully that should be useful for anyone trying to bring it up on any uncommon architecture to follow along. So thank you for your talk.
You're welcome.